I will name Sahana Ojha. Who will speak for the motion? Imagine a future where you fall ill. You approach a doctor for some medication, but your condition worsens. You switch your medication till you exhaust all your options. Your disease has no known surgeries or radical therapy. You are finally left alone, without any treatment, without anywhere to go. This, my friends, is the future if we do not join forces and advocate positively for human clinical trials. A human clinical trial is an experiment or an observation done in a clinical research. It helps develop and refine new treatments, therapies, and diagnostic procedures. With our generation trespassing into the fourth generation of drugs due to rampant self-administration, due to abuse and overuse of drugs, and new discoveries halted in the name of unethical practices, we will soon have no drugs, no therapies, and no techniques. Contrary to popular belief, clinical trials in human subjects are in fact the final phase of drug trials. The first phase is when the drug is extensively tested and developed. The first and second phase. The third phase is when the drug is tested on animals. And only when the drug passes through all these phases is it actually applied onto humans. It is initially employed onto smaller pilot groups and then extrapolated onto larger subpopulations. The process of recruitment in a clinical trial is not what it is usually perceived to be. There is no bribing, there's no coercing, there's no convincing. It is an absolutely legal procedure where the person involved in the trial has to sign a legal document stating that he knows all the clauses of the trial, knows all the side effects of the trial. And in some states, it is even mandatory for an advocate to be present during the signing of such a document. Let's look at the case of 4-year-old Ashanti Silva. She was a bright, happy child who suddenly saw no future for herself because she had a debilitating disease known as severe combined immunodeficiency. Two scientists in the 1990s went forward with a revolutionizing technique. They tried it for the first time, gene therapy, and now she is a thriving adult. If they would not have gone forward with this kind of therapy, with this kind of trial on a human, she would not be living today. My opponents might say that clinical trials on animals are enough, but the physiology of an animal and the physiology of a human are starkly different. And if we do not try on humans and we directly release the drug onto the entire population, a larger group of people will be badly affected. To conclude, I would like to state that curiosity is the mother of discovery, but necessity is the mother of invention. And friends, it is now time that we are in the dire necessity of these drugs and therapies. So, for the greater good of humanity, let's make humane human trials legal.
Actually, I read what you said. See, clinical trials are never done in animals. Whatever is done in animal models is always called a preclinical trial. Clinical trials are always done in human beings. And the third phase is not on animals. Trials which are done in human beings only have something called a phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, and phase 4, which of course I will not go into now. So do you know anything about that? It's about the correction of some factual error. Now, do you know what is audio visual consenting? How is it carried out and how does it help?
I'm not sure about audio visual consenting.
How do you think that how many clinical trials have to be done for a drug to be said that yes, it can be used now?
I'd like to quote somebody at this point, a researcher from Caltech. She said that you don't need 100 clinical trials or 1,000 clinical trials. You need maybe only 10, but they should be done carefully. All the examples of clinical trials that have gone wrong, put forward by people here, have always involved some negligence on the part of the examiners. So, clinical trials, if done carefully, if done legally, in its purest form, are in fact beneficial and are also legal processes. They have no type of any malpractice involved in them.
Since we are out of time, we cannot have questions from the audience.